Okay, so we'll see a consignment cycle. Basically, what is a consignment? Consignment is a process where vendor will keep some material in our plant, in our company, but this material is still owned by the vendor. We have not yet purchased it. The liability, we are not liable for the payment of this material, and the liability will get generated only when you pull that stock from the consignment to your own stock. That time only you are liable for the payment. So this is what is vendor consignment, where the material is lying in our premises but the vendor or the owner of the material is still the vendor, and it is not valued in our inventory. It is your stock account does not increase because of this consignment stock. Okay, so we'll see how it works in SAP. First, what I'll do, the main thing is that info record is mandatory for the consignment cycle. So we'll first create an info record. ME11 is the transaction code. Say I have vendor 100, material T195, purchasing organization 1000, plant 1000. Now the same material I can purchase as a standard, wherein whenever I do the goods receipt I am liable for the payment, or I can purchase it as a consignment also. What I will do, I will create both the info records and will show you what is the difference, how system identify the correct info record in this cycle. Okay, so first I will create a standard info record, which is a normal procurement cycle, and so for the normal purchase, the price is 15 euro. I'll save this. And same info record I'll create for consignment. And for consignment, say the price is 20. So for normal it is 15, consignment it is 20. This is just an example I'm taking. And I'll save this. Okay. Now I'll create a purchase order, and the transaction code is ME21N. Say the vendor is 100. Material is T195. And quantity say 100 is required. Okay. Just press enter and system will find out an info record. If you see, this info record has been identified. If I go to conditions, this is price is 15 euros, which means the price has been taken from the normal info record, right? Now when I select this item category, when I go to the item category and I will select here consignment, so when I select consignment and double click this and press enter, the conditions tab in purchase order will disappear. So your consignment purchase order does not have the price in the purchase order, because you don't know when you are going to use that material and what is the price on that particular day. So your prices are taken from the info record, which is a which you will keep updating as and when you go on with the price revisions. So in consignment PO there is no conditions tab, no purchase order rate. Okay, now I'll save this. Okay. And we'll do the goods receipt for this material. This is the PO number, and I'll go to transaction MIGO, MIGO. Okay, I'm doing goods receipt against purchase order. Execute this. Okay, item. Okay, so I am receiving a quantity of 100, and if I go to the where tab, this is GR for the consignment stock. The movement type is 101, and the next column, the special stock is K. K stands for consignment, so this is a special stock. K is consignment. Okay, so it will update the consignment stock. Now before I post this goods receipt, if I check the stock overview, from here I can go to the inventory So this is zero quantity stock. This is a new material. So the total stock is zero and value is also zero. If I go to material master accounting view, if I double click on this material code here, I'll double click and go to the accounting one for plant 1000. So the total stock now is zero, value is also zero. Okay. And now I'll post this goods receipt. Okay, so the document has been posted. Now if I go to display document, display, it will show you the last created material document, and press enter, so it will display the last created material document. And from here, now if I go to the stock overview, this stock overview button in the where tab, okay, so here you can see that still your own stock is zero, but there is a vendor consignment stock of 100. And if you double click on this, it will show you which vendor and what is the stock available. It is in the unrestricted use stock. Okay. Then in the same way, now if I go to the material master MM03 and to the accounting view for plant 1000, still your own stock is zero and value is also zero. So this vendor consignment stock is not owned by us. It is still owned by the vendor. So it is not valuated in our inventory. If you check this document info tab and try to look out for the FI document, so no subsequent documents found in accounting. It means for the consignment goods received, there is no FI document posted, no material valuation, no inventory posting. Okay. Now when you need this material, then what we do is we do the transfer posting from consignment stock to our own stock. Okay. And that moment type is 411, special stock type is K. So I will do that. Now I am in Migo only. So what I'll do, I'll say transfer posting, and here you will say others. Movement type is 411. Enter the movement type here, 411, and the special stock in the next field is K, consignment. So 411 K. Okay. Material is T195, plant 1000, storage location 0001. Here you will give the vendor. 100 is the vendor, and so now out of 100 I just want to transfer 20 quantity here. Okay, and I'm putting it in the same storage location. The movement type here is 411 K. This is important. Sometimes they may ask you in interview. Okay, check post. Okay, now if I again display this document, I'll again go to display, and this is the last created document, so execute. Okay, now if I see the stock overview here from this icon, so you can see that out of 100 consignment stock, 20 has been pulled in your own inventory, and you are liable for the payment of 20. This 80 is still owned by the vendor. It is vendor consignment. Okay, then if I go to the material master now, double click on any anywhere in the material code and go to the accounting view for plant 1000, and now here you can see that your total stock is 20 and value is 400. Okay, so this is what is a consignment transfer from consignment stock to own stock. And now if you check the accounting document here, if I go to the document info FI documents, so accounting document is generated, and you can double click and check that. So account posting happen when you pull from the consignment to own. Okay. Now there is one transaction code to see the list of consignment stocks in a plant, and that transaction code is MB54. So if I run the transaction MB54 and I want to check what is the consignment stack in plant 1000, or I can look it for a particular vendor, particular material, everything. So I want to check the consignment stock in plant 1000 and execute this. So here you can see this is your material and these are the vendors, how much quantity is available, what is the price and what is the value. So through that we can see what is the value of that material. Okay, so T195 is the material, 100 vendor, 80 quantity consignment is available, 20 is the price. This is taken from info record. There was no price in purchase order and 1600 euro is the value at this price. Okay, now the last step is settlement. When we purchase from the vendor, we need to, when we pull it in our own stock, but we need to pay to the vendor. Now since this is lying in our premises, vendor doesn't know when we have taken how much material. So in this case, vendor does not send the invoice and we do the automatic settlement, or we settle the invoice liability on our own, and that is done in transaction code MRKO. Okay, so here I'll say the company code is 1000 and I can select vendor 100, plant 1000, and material is T195. Now you consignment and pipeline both are settled in the same transaction. So here I'll select consignment. You have two options, display and settle. So first in the display mode it will display if there is any error, and if not then you can settle. So I'll execute this. Okay, so the info is not settled, and click back. I'll click on select settle. So select this radio button, settle, and execute. Now this has been settled and this accounting document has been generated. So if you click on this, it will show you the account posting. So vendor has been credited the 400 euros. This rate was taken from the info record. So all your tax information and record must exist in the info record. You have seen that there was no rate in the purchase order. So info record is mandatory for this cycle to complete. Okay, so that's it in the consignment cycle. It is a simple process and easier to understand. You need to remember a few points. That's it. Okay, thank you.